Hawaii volcano eruption latest. Hawaii rocked by 12,000 earthquakes in past 30 days. Hawaii's Big Island has been rocked by over 12,000 earthquakes in the past 30 days, according to the United States Geological Survey, USGS, far outstripping the island's monthly average of 1,000 quakes. While most of the earthquakes have been relatively mild at magnitude 2 or 3, the largest earthquake was a massive 6.9 magnitude tremor on May 4, along with a 5.5 magnitude quake on June 4. Brian Shiro, a supervisory geophysicist at the USGS Hawaiian Volcano Observatory, said the island was witnessing the highest rate of quakes ever measured at the summit. The earthquake on June 4 sent up an 8,000-foot ash plume, according to scientists, yet the tallest ash plume reached a height of 30,000 feet, according to the USGS. Lava spewing from the volcano and fissures in the lower east rift zone has covered an area of around 7.7 square miles, representing roughly 0.2% of the island, according to the USGS. Most recently, lava flows from fissure 8 engulfed Kapo'o Bay, creating a lava field that extends 0.8 miles from the old coastline and which has completely reshaped the coastline. The USGS commented on the destruction, saying, "Overflight confirms vacation land area completely covered, flows extended 100 yards north in Kapo'o beach lots. Lava entering ocean at vacation land, no other changes to flow field, fissure 8 founding still strong." Janet Snyder, a spokeswoman for Hawaii County, confirmed numerous homes had been destroyed in Kapo'o Bay, Kapo'o beach lots, and vacation land. She said, "We don't have an estimate yet, but safe to say that hundreds of homes were lost in Kapo'o beach lots and vacation land on Tuesday night." Willow Kabe, the county managing director, reported his second home in Kapo'o beach lots was also threatened. He said, "For us it's more of a vacation area, but for those who live there permanently, they're trying to figure out where they're going to be living." Talmadge Magno, Hawaii County Civil Defense Administrator, compared the lava flow entering Kapo'o Bay to a flood. He said, "It's just pouring out, covering everything in its path." Hawaii County Mayor Harry Kim offered reassurance to residents whose homes had been destroyed by the lava flows, stating, "I know how it hurts inside, so let's go from there on what we can do. In the darkest of times, I ask you to stick with us. Together, all of us as a community, if we have the will, we will make it better." Tracy Gregg, associate professor of geology and volcano expert at the University of Buffalo, also warned the coastline around Kapo'o Bay had been permanently altered. She said, "Whenever you have ocean entry, as we call it, we get a tongue of new land. Sometimes it's stable, but most of the time it's not. Whatever happens, Kapo'o will never be a cute little bay again, Kapo'o."